the house the special place for 7 interns studying under me. There it is, the Timothy House Project. Help me establish a house for young interns to train for ministry here at the Wisdom Center. Sow your seed with expectation. Are you one of the Timothy House sponsors? Call now. Now, is that the number? I don't know if that's the number here. Let me give you the number here. Here's the number. Put the live internet telephone on the number. Can you put that? 817-509-1385. There it is. There it is. Can you keep that up there the entire time until we reference something else? That is our live call center right now. My intercessors are here to pray with you, talk to you, share with you, receive any seed that you want to plant toward the... I had a lady this week sent me a piece of jewelry with an appraisal of it, and said, sell this and sow it into the Timothy House. Can you believe that? A piece of jewelry. That's wonderful. Maybe you have some old jewelry laying around and it's just doing nothing. Flo, my sister asked me a few days ago, she said, nothing. Flo, my sister asked me a few days ago, she said, what's inspired you for your cars or for your, she was talking about my briefcases, because I have a briefcase collection that I adore. I mean, it would take 3 angels to get one of my briefcases. I love my briefcases. I collect them and use them all over the world. And I said, sis, I got to thinking about the man with 1 talent, and he didn't use it. There's a curse on anything that's not being used. Anything that's not producing. God hates anything that doesn't multiply. God hates anything that doesn't multiply. Think about that. Think about that. And so we've got several things. Let me show you some pictures. Let me show you Pastor Anna. Let me show you Pastor Anna. Can you, you ready for some picture taking? Okay. This is when Pastor Anna Sweet from Denver, Colorado, right here. This is when she was 20 years old. Interpreting for me, translating for me. This is Pastor Saul Gonzalez, her mentor, who came to all my conferences. What a man of God. He's going to be with Jesus. And his son, Pastor Saul Gonzalez, we're working very closely with this great church in Puerto Vallarta. He just sent me this beautiful ring as a gift. Isn't that gorgeous? Wipe the jealousy off your face, family. Wipe the jealousy off. This is a blessing. I'd have never bought myself a ring like this, Miss Viviana. I'd have never bought myself, so God had to give it to me. Don't you like it? Well, the studio is just full of the odor of jealousy. There is not one happy person in this studio happy for my ring, so I'm just going to hold it up there the whole time. This is Pastor Anna Sweet. This is what happens when you get the Holy Ghost. This is her new picture. This is her. Praise God. What do you think about this? Miss Amanda, come over here and stand here for a moment. She's probably watching us right now. I just texted her and told her I was going to be on the internet live here. Her husband, Arturo, has been with me all over the world. Isn't she a knockout of a lady? That's her at 20. What does that mean, Mike? It means the younger you are, the uglier you are. It means when you get older, you'll get good looking again, better and better. What do you think? What's your thoughts? Can you come up close where they can? Can you get a shot of this young lady here? Miss, come up close where they can. Can you get a shot of this young lady here? Miss Amanda, come stand here. This is a young lady that God led me to invest in her business in Denver, Colorado. And I tell you, I was so blessed by her. One night, we were sitting there, and she says to me, because she goes to Pastor Anna Christ's Church. And they're in Denver, Colorado. By the way, what's her website?
It's annasweetministries.com.
Let me put a, got an extra microphone over there anywhere? Ah, good.
It's annasweetministries.com.
And she mentored you, brought you really to the power of God.
Yes, sir.
What do you think of her picture when she was to get that family? This is what God can do. This is what God.
She never lied to me.
Tell me about the questions you wrote. That greatly impressed me.
Yes, on December 23rd of 2012, I was here at the Wisdom Center for the very first time, and I heard you say about the question.
That's huge. I forgot. I have one. I forgot. I say this over and over. It's the voice you trust decides your future. The voice you trust. Let me show you the voice I trust that brought great blessing to my life. I've been making TV programs, and you'll see all these pictures in the days ahead. Here they are. This woman right here changed my life. She gave me life. That's my mother. She gave me life. She believed the Bible worked. She believed that every answer I ever needed was in the Scriptures. My father was an example. Prayed a lot, 4 to 10 hours a day. That's all I remember. Other children have different memories. That's my memory of my father. Built 7 churches. Had 9 children, 2 died, 7 lived. Daddy's 97 years old. You probably saw him 2 days ago here at the Wisdom Center. We brought him up to the front. And my sister Flo and her husband, Pastor Lee Warner, oversee Daddy. This is my mentor. She believed that God would rip your hide off if you disobeyed him. She believed it was dangerous to not have a fear of God. She believed that if you didn't obey God, God could mess you up fast. She believed that. This is my mother. Thank God. She's in glory right now in heaven. And mother, thank you. Thank you for teaching me the law of honor. She believed in the fear of the Lord. She believed that everything that we needed was through the word of God. And when she got upset with God, she would very mouthy about it. She would say what she didn't. She was upset. Let me give you some other pictures. This is me teaching for Dr. Lester Sumrall in Israel. Millions of people watch these telecasts. As I went there, I've probably been to Israel probably 8 to 10 times. I saw Renee Terranova from Manaus, Brazil. I've spoken there for Frida Lindsay, which reminds me I dreamed about her about 3 nights ago. I went there with her and helped her in her Christ for the Nations projects. I've been there. I took Daddy there when he was 80. And we were on our way from Spain, I think it was. And I said, Daddy, you've never been to Israel. Let's just stop over. So I stopped over and rented a guide and taxi and took Daddy everywhere, all over Israel, Bethlehem, Jericho, the little sycamore tree stuff, all that stuff right there. That's me preaching in Israel. This is my 48th year in ministry. That's a half a century. here's one of my best friends growing up. He's the smartest friend I grew up with, me and him and Jesse Duplantis. And this young man's name is Alton Garrison, the best pianist I ever heard out of this world. He and his wife, Betty. And I preached for his father. I like lifetime friends. I like people who last. And the people who last with me are honest people. They're people of integrity. I don't do well with liars. Liars don't seem to grow well in my life. Here is my master mentor next to the Holy Spirit. This is the man of God that taught me to listen to the voice of God. My daddy's hair turned white in 6 months from a church problem. He pastored in Lake Charles, Louisiana, and there's a farm came available for a real low price, 40 miles up the street, up the road in Ritter, Louisiana. And Daddy put his money together and put some things together and decided he would buy that little farm. I think it was 18 acres. And his board found out about it, the same board that didn't give him one raise for 10 solid years. They paid him $125 a week for 10 solid years. They never raised him a dime. I don't know where they are. They may be in heaven. If so, anybody can go. This is my dad. And when they found out he had bought that little farm, they turned on him, very upset with him, and they would not let him preach his resignation service. And his hair turned white in truth. If you're a pastor watching tonight, don't get discouraged if your son doesn't believe you. Don't feel down if your daughter decides not to trust you. Truth is only embraced by truth lovers. Truth is only embraced by truth lovers. I had to make a decision to embrace my father as a father or a man of God. He was not articulate in personal things. Still isn't. He just sat there and look at you and smile. And he loved mother because mother talked so well. Mother was very articulate, great, great conversationalist, and very nice. And my daddy loved that in her. And here's my dad eating his favorite. That's ice cream. I have the same little devil in me that loves ice cream. He is contented. You see that brain there? He's not thinking of anything else but ice cream. Nothing else but ice cream, that's all. So to him and say, I killed 14 people last night. And he'd say, uh-huh. And others, a missionary. And I told Morris Plotts. Morris Plotts is a great missionary to Africa. And he was known as Bwana, B-W-A-N-A, Bwana Tembo. To praise the Lord. Why did you come here? And he gave his life to Christ, brought us to that village. We were able to see many won to Christ. Kasumu, Kakamega, Navasha, where all the pink flamingos are, Mombasa on the coast, Dar es Salaam, Tanzania, Jerry Spain and Connie's Bible college there. I just went down the hall and got these a few minutes ago and decided I would show you some things that's happening here. You see this picture? This boy is serious about the kingdom of God. I love the work of God. I believe that the proof of God is change. I believe that the Bible is infallible. I believe that any person who crosses with God will experience horrible consequences. I believe that the God that I serve and the God that I've experienced is a God of the supernatural. Out of my mouth in one day, over 600 worms. My father went to prayer that night, lifted up his hands. We're going to pray all night. And he prayed this prayer: Thou art a mighty God. Thou art a mighty God. And after 4 or 5, while he was praying that one sentence prayer, he saw Satan holding me at 2.5 years old in his arms. And Jesus walked over to Satan and gently took me out of Satan's arms. 9/13/85. This will tell you the story of my healing. How God set me free when doctors had given me up to die. When I was 18, I went to St. Patrick's Hospital to get an examination to go to Bible college. And my doctor's name was Dr. DeGiulie. And he looked at me shocked and said, you were the baby that was going to die. 16 years later, he gave me a bill of health. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns. He reigns. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. In this book, I have 407 scriptures on divine healing. Over 400 scriptures for you to memorize. If you're a pastor and you'd like to have 10 copies of this, you can have it for $20. I'll pay the postage. But if you're a pastor, you want to look at this? This is the ideal gift for anybody you visit in the hospital. Every preacher watching me right now ought to call. And just a $20 bill, just a $20 bill, and I'll send you 10 copies to give to people that you're visiting in the hospital. And if you want 100 copies, I'll send them to you for $100. 100 copies for $100. It's a $5 book that you can have for a single dollar bill. So if you call the number 817-509-1385, and if you tell one of my intercessors, send me Mike's book, Passport for Health and Healing, she will take your bank card number and we'll send you 100 copies for $100. That's better than a $50 bunch of roses that's better for them by far. Here's my children here at the Wisdom Center. Can you see that? Does he want to reach inside of a woman and destroy and stop somebody from having the gift of life on the earth? Boy, what kind of person loves killing babies? Woo! And they're not even in jail. They're not even in jail. They're walking free. They get on the news at night. Isn't that amazing? But I'm a baby lover. Don't you love these children? Boy, you can't be around a child and not want to protect them and love them. And whew. God, Jesus had something real fascinating. Very fascinating. About children. He said, if you offended a child, I would imagine killing a child would be offensive to Jesus. He said, if you offend a child, it would be better that a millstone be hung around your neck and you go be drowned. Wow. I don't I don't know if that's a Joel Osteen Jesus, but it's a biblical Jesus. I don't know if it's a Mike Murdock Jesus, but it's a biblical Jesus. It'd be better that a millstone be hung around your neck. I need some signs out here keeping me posted on everything, guys. I need some signs out here. Would you write down to get me a clap track for Prophet Marquez, since he won't clap for me? Nobody here in the studio will clap for me. Thank you. I'm going to walk you through some special gifts that we have for those who help us on the Timothy House. We have just a few minutes left. I want two young men to join, but before we go any further, I want them to come stand up here. And they speak English about 1,000 times better than I speak Portuguese. You've got some microphones for them, I'm sure. God bless you, son. It's so good to have both of you here. We've been hugging and praying together and loving God together. And they've got some microphones for you. They're going to be bringing them. Oh, you're already mic'd up. How nice. Well, that is thinking ahead. Paul, you and I talked one night. Remember that after service?
I remember.
And you sowed an incredible seed that night. I remember you holding in your hand. We prayed. Let's see which is the right camera to look at. This is a good camera right here. Tell us how the Lord has used our ministry for you and your brother. Son, you coming here excites me. You told me you was going to come here. You said, I'm coming to the Wisdom Center. And you and I talked back and forth on Twitter. I started following you last. You get my tweet. Talk to me. And then introduce your brother. Tell us about your life. Tell us how God has used the seed message. You're called into the ministry.
Yeah,
called to preach this gospel. Talk to us. Right. Talk right there. And I have partners that are watching from different parts of the world. They haven't brought me a geography map to show where everybody's going to do an illustration for him or what. Is it on now? Was it on before? Is his on? You want to crawl over there and see if his is on? Okay, go ahead, Paul.
So I would like to thank the earth and made possible everything that's happening in my life. And second of all, I would like to thank my mother for her life, for bringing me to Jesus as your father brought you to Jesus.
Yes.
And for teaching me. She is my master mentor after the Holy Spirit. And she just taught me about the seed, about the gospel. But my mind wasn't really open to the Lord since I first listened to Dr. Murdock. He is a man that completely changed the way I see people, the way I think, and everything that you can imagine. He changed in my mind. I have an iPad and I've downloaded an app in which I can download videos from YouTube. In this app, I've downloaded many and many of Dr. Murdock's videos, and my family and I, we keep listening to him. Sometimes I leave home and go to job and go to work listening to Murdock. I am not listening just to a man, but I'm listening to the Word of God. I put a Bible in my bed because I saw in his tweet that he said that he sleeps with the Bible on the bed. So I picked up my Bible and put it in my bedroom. 24/7, there are songs playing to God, even Murdock songs at my bedroom. And a song that really taught my heart, that really came to my life was Bring Me the Broken. I'm not a good singer. I can't sing it. But I've been listening it, and Holy Spirit told me that I have to be his power. And I've been praying, bring me the broken. Lord has been bringing me so many people in a way I could never imagine. I've been helping people with emotional problem, financial problem, any kind of problem. Even a woman came to me and said, man, you are just a young man and was helping me with my marriage. You are not married and you could help me. I am okay with my husband because I've been learning about wisdom. I put in my heart that wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom with all thy getting. I am looking for wisdom in America. I flew from Brazil to the Wisdom Center. I didn't come to America. So thank you, Dr. Mike Murdock, for every single word you've said at the Wisdom Center at the conference. I went to Rio de Janeiro in Brazil, and when I was there, I took an offer, a seed, and I sent in my pocket, and I was there to sow the seed in his ministry. I was ready for that because I learned it with my mom. I learned that I have got a soul so God can bring me. Because when I am ready to give money to God, I can prove that I really trust him. Once I was preaching and I said, do you really trust God? So put your hands on your pockets and bring money to God. Many people couldn't, a lot came. So those who can't take your money and give to the church or to the ministry are not able to say they are Christians because they love money. They are those who put their trust in money. I gave my offer to Dr. Murdock Ministry, but while I was in the church, he said about another seed. It was 8,500 reais. It's our money. It's like $4,000. And I didn't have that money, and I said, I'm going to give this money to the ministry. I gave it. I am not going to tell it was 1 month. Less than 1 month, my income doubled. I got a percentage of a new business. And I am a preacher. I never got a seed in my ministry. After I sold this seed in the Dr. Mike's ministry, I received my first seed in my ministry. Not only one, but several after that. That is amazing. You could say it's coincidence if it had happened before, but it didn't. Only after I sowed the seed. So money has power. Money can make you happy because you can pay your bills, you can feed your children, you can help a lot of people, even spread the gospel. You are only listening to me because there is money, which bought a camera, this studio,
yes.
Clothes, everything. So I challenge you to trust God. And I've been listening to Dr. Murdock saying about the Timothy House. You probably heard about it. And it was just burning in my heart. I was thinking about myself. I'm a young man. I'll do the best that I can so I can leave my job and come to the house. And please bring your seed and help this ministry. Because we're going to make a lot of young people worship the Lord. He is our Lord. He is who made you. I was having great times and excellent experience with the Holy Spirit because of what he told me. I couldn't see many things in the gospel that now I can see because Christians only look to the person of Jesus and not his principle. They do not pay attention at Solomon. They just pay attention at John 3:16. And they forget Mark 10:29 that you can have in the earth. Psalms 35:27, 1:12, a lot of parts of the Bible teaches that you can have money, financial blessings. God can give you what you are looking for. Just open your eyes. So astonished, so happy that I made a website because my brother told me. We went together to the Rio. After that, he told me, why don't you open a website and write everything you like? Since I was 8 years old, I've been preaching. When I was 13, I wrote a book, and I started my website talking about wisdom.
Yes.
I believe in the Word of God. I believe in the wisdom of God, and it changed my life. It changed my feeling, my happiness, and everything that you can think is changed in my life. Thank you, Dr. Murdock.
Thank you, sir.
First of all, thank you, Holy Spirit, for everything you did in my life, for this experience here. I've never been I've never seen someone with so great heart as you have. You hosted us, you took care of us in all the ways that you could, that I could never imagine it could happen in my life. I was expecting something, and it is 1,000 times better than I could imagine in my life.
Wow.
Thank you so much. God bless
you.
And I would like to tell you, believe in God. My brother has been someone who is inspiring me to keep in the Word of God, memorizing every single day of my life a new verse of the Bible, write psalms, because David wrote, and he said, write psalms. I'm going to worship the Lord with psalms. I am writing my psalms as David did, because I want to love God as David loved. So thank you so much for helping me. Thank you, Mommy, and everybody who is watching and believing in the Word of God. Thank you.
Praise God. Thank you, son, so much. Thank you. Thank you. That's worth everything to me. Everything to me. Talk to us about what God's doing in your life.
So,
what God's doing in your life.
So as my brother said, our life is watching a lot for this and praying to the Holy Spirit in my room, in my secret place, my room, and telling him that I really want to be a liar as my mom. And the Holy Spirit remembered me about one thing I read in a book of Dr. Mike Murdock. It's an uncommon seed brings an uncommon harvest. So I go to the bank and take off all money I have in my account, and this is my seed. And I say, the Holy Spirit, this is my seed, and I want to receive an uncommon harvest, is the be approved in this test. So in April of the last year, 2013, I was approved in this test for the thanks for all things you do for people's, for all your books that changes our lives, changes my mind, changed minds of my brother, and we really want to share with all peoples with me about the wisdom of God. As my brother said, we come to the United States just for this, just for a visit, and just to stay the biggest thing I ever knew about this, because the peoples, we can go there, go here, come here, and stay in the presence of God and learning about wisdom, learn about God and about the Holy Spirit. Thank you very much, Dr. Mike.
Thank you, son.
For
thank
everything.
You, son. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I want to just pray a special prayer of blessing right where you are. I remember Richard Roberts one time. I was at the City of Faith, and I went there every month for a good while. And Richard Roberts looked over me one day and said, Daddy and I need you to move here. And for 2 years, they really pushed. And if I ever missed the Lord, that sure is one place maybe I did. But at that time, I was too young to, I was in my early 30s. I didn't understand the power of, I didn't understand what Pastor Anna Sweet mentor to teach you, to speak to you. Then when there's an instruction, you don't go pray about it, because God just spoke to you through your mentor. I didn't understand that at the time at all. But he said something that I never forgot. He said, we need your faith here. He said, this is too big for one person's faith. And he said, as much faith as Daddy and I have, or Roberts, as much faith as we have. And he said, as much faith as Daddy and I have, or Roberts, as much faith as we have, this is too big. Our ministry is too large. We need people of faith to come with us. I want you to just stretch forth your hand toward your father. I thank you for their lives, their passion, their testimony. They've been swift to hear your voice. Swift to hear your voice. They believed, they embraced. Let the Word of God be more alive toward them and in them than it's ever been before. In them than it's ever been before. I ask you to open up doors unlike any they've ever seen. Open up doors. I set myself in covenant for them for all 14 miracles, all 14 harvests of Isaiah the 58th, there that rivers of favor will flow toward them. Doors of honor will be opened to them. let this message that burns like a fire in my heart, that's burning in their heart now, let this message go around the world. Let the gospel be received and embraced. Raise up young preachers. Raise up more young lawyers full of the Holy Ghost who loves your voice, who value your word. We sanctify their secret place that you will talk to them. They will document and journal their journey. And everything you do for me, do for them. Everything you do for me, do for them. Father, let every person who participates in the Timothy House see radical blessings, a surprise year of divine surprises in 2014. For you. When you see the gospel received, when you see the gospel received, you don't have what God gave you. You received the gifts. You have the gifts that you received, the gifts that you received. Every gift of God has to be received. I don't care if it's the blood of Christ. I don't care if it's salvation. John 1:11, he said, he came into his own, and his own received him not. But to as many as received him, to them gave he the power. I want to share some things with you, that ways to change your life. Some small ways, little keys swing big doors. A key could open a bank vault. It's amazing that you can, I was in a bank the other day, and there's got a huge bank vault. It's probably 8 feet by maybe 7 feet the other day, and there's got a huge bank vault. It's probably 8 feet by maybe 7 feet tall. Big bank vault. And it was open. Just has some numbers there. You punch the numbers and it opens. You close it, punch numbers. You open it, you close it. Keys. We call them keys to the kingdom, you know. There's things that you can do that bring a radical change in your life. Small. Hinges. Control big doors. Something I creates what I experience. Something I say creates what I experience. Death and life are in the power of the tongue. If you didn't hear church by phone today at 12 o'clock, you should have. You should have. Very powerful. Very strong. I had sent a message to 10 of my staff, 10 people on my team, about finding a certain thing on the internet that I wanted them to find. I guess it was a very simple thing, one thing. And then an hour later, I resent the message saying, have you had any success? It's been about an hour expanded time. Have you had any success? And I did it to 10 different people so I could measure and assess their response to me. None of them had received, to my knowledge, none of them had received a bunch of instructions that day from me. Just a little text. And I was wanting them to find a storage warehouse closest to the ministry here. We pay $5,000 plus a month for storage in Tulsa, Oklahoma, to a company that does some product fulfillment for us. When somebody orders a book, they mail the book for us. Plus, I had things in a truck that I was trying to unload, and I didn't have a place for them. And I've had two trucks here for hours and hours just holding my some of my furniture and some things, and kind of desperate, kind of anxious for that. Really wanted to. And I was shocked to see the difference in response. I was shocked to see how varied. One person didn't even answer me. Didn't even answer. And I asked him that night, why didn't you reply to me? Why didn't you say something to me? Why didn't you acknowledge? And there was no answer. When God gives us instructions, the reaction is so varied across Christianity. I'll never forget the night here at the Wisdom Center that the Lord shocked me, and I mean stunned. I should say he stunned me. I was preaching, and I made a statement. I was thinking about the book of Acts where the sorcerer wanted to give money for the gift of the Holy Ghost. And the man of God said, "May your money perish with you to think that you can buy anything from God with money." So I was thinking of that, and so I made a statement to our conference. I said, "You cannot buy a miracle from God." And it was just like a slap in my face. The Holy Spirit says, "Who told you that? Who told you that?" I said, "Well, you know, Book of Acts, the sorcerer. You know, about the gift of the tongues and speaking in tongues, and may your money perish with you." And all the preachers say that. We all say that you can't buy anything with money. We trivialize money in Christianity. Only religion could sell poverty to people. There's not a dummy on the earth stupid enough to buy a poverty life unless it was coupled with religion and God. And then God began to talk to me. The cross was the price of my salvation. The blood, the crucifixion. Jesus looked at the blind man and wiped clay and spittle on his eyes. Walked 2 miles to the pool of Siloam and washed it off. That was his price for his blindness to leave. Naaman pulls up at the house of Elisha, the prophet. He is the Assyrian general covered with leprosy. He's got boxes of gifts and silver and gold. And Elisha does not even go out to meet him. He sends his personal assistant. He sends his armor bearer out there and says, "Tell him that the price of leprosy healing today for him is to dip in Jordan 7 times, and on the 7th time, his leprosy will disappear." What was God's price for the walls of Jericho to fall? Walk around them 7 days in a row, and 7 times on the 7th day of Sunday. I call it Sunday. You got something for me? Thanks. What was that price? These scriptures. That the bed of languishing would be ended. That if I reached out to the poor, God would turn on my light in my nighttime and my health would spring forth speedily. Do you think I'm an expert on Portuguese if I say obrigada, which I think means thank you? Isn't there an obrigado and there's an obrigada in there too? two different ones? Do you think I'm a Portuguese because I can say obrigada? Or sim, is sim yes, S-I-M, sim? Is it yes, like C in Spanish, sim? Do you think because you know one chapter in the Bible that you know God? Do you think an experience is knowledge? If all I needed was an experience with God, why did he say 46 times to write the vision, make it plain, write what you've seen, write about where you've been? God's the teacher. Why did he say in Isaiah 1:17, learn to do well? Learn to do well. Mike, what are you saying? I'm saying we can change our life. We can change our world. We can make new decisions. When I started telling people, if you'll write 10 questions down every morning in the secret place, your income will double in 12 months. I don't have a single doubt about that. I don't have a single doubt that any preacher, any pastor listening to me right now, if every morning in the secret place, remember, the command is to ask. It's not an idea. It's not a suggestion. It's not a thought. It's a command. When I sent out this instruction to 10 different people, and I got 10 levels of passion, to some it didn't matter at all. So what if you want that? I don't care if that's the only thing you asked me today. It's not important to me. I'm not going to answer you. Boy, I just thought of the cost of familiarity is horrible. Wow. Could it be that the closer I get to somebody, the less they care? The closer I get to somebody, the less my words matter? And hurt me. Hurt me kind of bad. Hurt me kind of bad. Wow. 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 To think you're loved and you're not. To think you're honored and you're not. To think your words matter and they don't. So I came back to God's word. What was the last words of Jesus in the book of the Revelation? What was his last words? Do you remember? Hear. Hear what the Spirit says to the church. Hear. 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 I remember one day when I was 36 years old, standing in a private office with Dr. Oral Roberts. I didn't understand it then. He explained something about Abraham. He disagreed with me on tithe and the offerings. And he had called me in to teach to his top 15, James Winslow, Dr. Winslow, the head of his faith, city of faith, his top lawyer who was head of all the lawyers in his law school. And Ruth Rooks, who's been his secretary for like 40 years, called me, and I just finished making two TV programs with Richard Roberts. And she called and said, Dr. Roberts would like to see you in the press room. Well, he was mentoring me in so many ways that I thought he's wanting me to see how he talks to newspapers and television people. Meet him in the press room where he met with the media, press, TV people. When I walked in, there's 15 of us around a little U table. And I didn't know what he wanted. I didn't know. I just knew that he was the greatest man of God I knew personally as far as achievement. Nobody in history has ever done what he's done. Nobody. 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 He's an achiever. Massive, massive productivity. Massive ministry. All over the world. And to have the privilege of just being talked to by him just was ferocious to me. Just too good to be true. And he got up and he says, I've called y'all together today as the leaders of our ministry here for you to interrogate Mike. as long as you want to. We'll stay here as many hours as you want to do it. But he said, I've been listening to him talk, and he's saying things I've never heard in my life. I've never heard from any man. So I want you to interrogate him. Somebody lifted a hand. I think Gary is chaplain of his ministry. He said, what can we talk? What can we question him about? He said, anything, anything, anything you want to ask him. I'm sitting there, Lord, I don't even hardly know the difference between an adverb and a verb, an adjective and an adverb. I just know I love the Word of God, and I love the voice of God. I love the voice of the Spirit. That's all I know. I'm 36 years old. I've gone through a horrifying marriage failure, and I'm trying to get back on my feet, and I don't have any money. And you know what I had? I carried my clothes. I carried my clothes. This is kind of funny. I carried my suits and my shirts and my ties in the plastic bag from the cleaners everywhere in the world. That's why. That shows you how bright I really am. I didn't even have a garment bag. Now him and Richard bought me some Louis Vuitton later, which I thought was the ugliest luggage I'd ever seen, and I asked if I could trade it back in for some pretty luggage. But I just didn't know anything, didn't. But he said that. And they interrogated me for several hours. Then he called me to the side and he interrogated me more hours. And we had a disagreement on tithe. The Bible says the tithe is the Lord's. I had assumed that the 90% is mine. And he said something powerful. He said, if I tell you this chair is mine, does that mean that sofa you're sitting on isn't? Said, all this furniture's mine. If I tell you this chair is mine, does that mean that chair isn't? That table isn't? And then he brought me, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. It's all his. It's all his. The tithe isn't payment of a debt. It's the acknowledgement of the debt. When I give God $10 out of $100, I haven't paid God off. I'm not free with the 90%. And then he said, when he got through presenting, he says, tell me now what I just told you. Tell me what I just told you. I said, I understand. He said, no, tell me. And he asked. And I don't know what was wrong with me, but my mind was paralyzed. So I said, I understand. I said, no, you tell me back what these scriptures are saying, what I just told you. You tell it back to me. And I couldn't. Every problem in your life is a wisdom problem. It's a wisdom problem. I have a passion to learn. I have a need to learn. Mike Murdock has such needs. There's so much I don't know. I love sitting at your feet. I love hearing what you say. I love that song. I wish they'd play it for me. I love sitting at your feet. I love hearing what you say. I love knowing your desires. I'm so pleasured to obey. Your favor is like a sunrise, driving all my nights away. I love sitting at your feet. What part of God do you not know about? What part of God have you not experienced? One Friday morning, I was teaching for Benny Hinn in a big conference here with 22,000 people here in Dallas. And Benny, a longtime friend, asked me to speak for him. He told me one day, said, Mike, there's an anointing on you for finances like God has anointed me for healing. And he said, I wish you would write a book for me for my partners. And I wrote the book, 31 Reasons People Do Not Receive Their Financial Harvest. On Sunday morning after his conference, I think there was a Thursday and a Friday night, I spoke Friday morning, a pastor of a huge church of over 20,000 people, I think it was 18,000 people, a big church here in Dallas, went on TV blasting Benny Hinn. He said, Jesus Christ does not heal today. He said, Jesus Christ does not heal today. Jesus Christ does not heal today. And I'm sitting there thinking, old Murdock vocabulary, are you stupid? I got to come up with some better words. That's not a nice word. Are you crazy? Are you an idiot? Then he said, tongues is of the devil. People who speak in tongues are of the devil. And I love this preacher. He's good. He's a good man. There's not a doubt in my mind he's a good man. Not a doubt in my mind he's a good man. Not a doubt. He speaks Greek and Hebrew, and he reads Greek, and he reads the Bible in Hebrew. So this is not a Murdock country bumpkin from Louisiana. This boy knows some stuff. But he didn't know that part about God. He didn't know anything about the prayer language. Isn't that crazy? Somebody he trusted led him wrong. Those who transfer knowledge can transfer error. And when I heard him, my heart was just, he'll go to heaven. He's a good man. He's just wrong, that's all. There's a lot of people wrong on doctrine. There's a lot of stuff I don't know about. I don't know when Jesus is coming. I don't know. Bible said we don't know the day nor the hour. And I used to say, well, at least we should know the year. But I don't know. I don't know. I really don't know if he's coming before the 7 years or in the middle of the 7 years or after the 7-year tribulation. I don't really know. 7-year tribulation. I don't really know. I don't really know. I don't know. I've studied it. I've studied different, but I don't know. But the part about Jesus, 83, and his whole research team put it together. He's got a list of here what the Bible means by sacrifices. He has a list of the feast in the year of Jubilee, what the altar was about, what tithe is about, what the first fruits is about. He's got all kind of prosperity profiles. He's done a whole lifetime of study, and he called it the Financial Freedom Bible. It's the most information about biblical money and prosperity I've ever seen. And so I was talking about it on television earlier today, and the thought hit me. I lived 18 years in a home of a wonderful, fabulous man of God who never one time do I recall saying, if I sowed a seed and focus it for a harvest, I could create a harvest. There's so much of God we don't know. But the part I do know, I cling to and I believe. I believe with all my heart. I believe with all of my heart. what part of the Bible have you chosen? Doubt I over the anger about prosperity, about money. Don't you want a car that won't break down? Don't you want to live in a house in a safe neighborhood? Don't you? Don't you want to be able to buy some books for your children? Wouldn't you like to put somebody through Bible school? Why this anger over prosperity? It has to be demonic. It has to be satanic that you would be. It has to be demonic. It has to be satanic that you would be even against. And we're not against money. Everybody goes to work 8 hours a day to get some. I don't know. There has to be a demonic blindness that comes on people's lives. Demonic blindness to finish our assignment. Every preacher I know tells me, if I had money, I could go on television. If I had more money, I could be on the radio. If I had some money, I could have a stadium filled with 100,000 people. If I could advertise, if I just had some money, I could hire a youth pastor. If I had some money, I could. He's that he used, and I liked it. He said, the bigger you make your corner to God, the bigger God will make your field. I never heard 53 Chevrolet. Cost mother $300 to buy it. The house I was living in cost $150. My father bought the house and moved it on some land he had. Just dawned on me again that I had no money and I'd surrendered the ministry, but the land that Daddy owned belonged to the Highway and Hedge Evangelism. It was land he had bought to put a church, a little church, but he moved this old house for $150. He bought it and moved it there. That's where I lived my first 8 years of my evangelism. Interesting. Territorial anointing. And I stood and I made. A man came up to me and he said, you just trying to get my $58. I said, do I look like a $58 man to you? Do I look like the kind of guy I'd be happy at $58? I said, I want to tell you something. If I was taking money away from you, I'd strip you of everything you had, and I'd take your clothes off too and take your car. You know, if I'm going to go to jail for stealing, it won't be from 7-Eleven. If I wasn't a believer, No. I'm going to go after it, I'm going to go after it. That's why this Bible means everything to me. Everything to me. Everything to me. There are three harvests I want to release for 2014 into your life. Number one, your health shall spring forth speedily. God wants me well. Never forget, Brother Oral Roberts called me one day and said, Mike, I want you to write a theme song. God wants you well, and so do I. God wants you whole and fully alive. I wrote that theme song. They sung it around the world. God wants you well. God, I receive healing for my body. I receive restoration. The second harvest is territorial wisdom, that the decisions you make will create land possession for you. I believe the first gift God gave to a human was land. The only man in the Bible we recall Jesus calling, God calling him his personal friend, was Abraham. And he repeatedly told Abraham, I will bless you. How? In the land. In the land. And the moment he removed the seed of strife, who was his nephew, Lot, the moment on our ministry and our life, and I've never even wanted it. I never asked for it. I think it came through the 112 covenant on the 112th Psalm. That's the way I think it came. But all I know is it's here. It's explosive. It's explosive. I looked at a pastor in Argentina, and I said, there's a territorial anointing on my life. And I said, I'm going to lay hands on you, and territory is going to come to you. It wasn't 3 minutes till people from all over the church. I know of 5 homes and pieces of property that were given to him within less than 2 minutes. And a man met me in his office after church and gave me land in Argentina from 1,800 acres that he had. I love sitting at your feet. I love hearing what you say. The third harvest is a financial relationship. A financial relationship. Somebody that believes in you. Somebody that believes in you. Somebody that believes in you. Somebody who believes in you. A huge check came. Huge check came. I've never written a check that big for the kingdom of God. From a man in Brazil. Just the last few weeks. He heard me talk about the $1,000 seed. And he was sitting in a restaurant. Alone at a table, and a strange man walked into the restaurant and walked over to him and said, the Spirit is telling me to tell you a secret formula, and I want to tell you that it came from the days of the Egyptians and the pyramids and in the days of Pharaoh. The pyramids and in the days of Pharaoh. And the Spirit's telling me to tell you the formula. And he received it. His business exploded. And he's got homes all over the world. He writes me a note. I'm sending you my tithe for this week of my company. Because it was through you and the $1,000 seed that a stranger walked into my world and my life. And I'm blessed. He sent me a bunch of pictures through one of those dream homes, mansions. God will leave no man unrewarded. Father, in 12 minutes, I ask you for 12 seeds. In 12 minutes, I ask you for 12 seeds. In 12 minutes, I ask you for 12 seeds of a $1,000 seed for the Timothy house. In the next 12 minutes, talked to 12 people who need territorial anointing. That the decisions they make for a home or a house or land will be mighty, glorious. I ask you to provide them debt-free homes like you've given me a debt-free home. I ask you for territorial anointing like they've never even imagined. I ask you to curse every seed of disease and sickness in their body, that not one member of their family will suffer violence or disease from the top of their heads to the soles of their feet. I set myself in covenant with you that no sickness can dominate your home and your environment. The healing river of Jesus of Nazareth be a portion of your harvest. I pray for your children because you're helping a young Timothy, some young Joshua will pack his bags in the next 12 weeks and make plans to come to the Wisdom Center because of you. Somebody will go to Tanzania and Kenya and Somalia. Somebody will go to Egypt and Syria. Somebody will go to India. Somebody will go to Australia and Brazil. Somebody will go around the world and preach this gospel because of your seed. I sanctify this $1,000 seed for the Timothy House, and not one penny will go in Mike Murdock's pocket. Not one cent will buy me any clothes or a tie. That every penny that you sow will enter not only the Timothy House, but into the people that live in it as young prophets of the Lord. I set myself in covenant for a financial relationship with you, that somebody's going to like you. Somebody's going to be good to you. You don't need everybody liking you. You need the right person liking you. I have relatives that's never planted a single dollar bill in the vision. I've got partners who've never planted a $10 bill in the Timothy House. I've got people that's never sowed one seed into the Timothy House for young preachers, not one. But God has sent somebody. And God will send somebody to bless you. Your father may never give you a car. Your son may never buy you a home. But this gospel works. This gospel works. This gospel works. This gospel works. There's not a shred of doubt in my life, in my mind, that the 300,000 will come in. We already have over 107,000. Not a doubt in my mind. But what's the biggest thing to me is to get a seed into the soil. I look for good soil. Good soil's too rare to ignore. If Jesus told the truth that a cup of cold water given to a man of God produces the reward system of a man of God. If it's true that if I believe a prophet, I will prosper. If that's true, I'd be a fool not to sow into the kingdom. There's 12 phone calls, 12 people, maybe more. If God's speaking to you to be one of the 12, I have some wonderful ways to celebrate your seed of 1,000. You will receive the complete Bible, researched by Dr. Morris Cyril and his research team, called the Financial Freedom Bible. It'll be the only Bible you'll ever need to understand God's ideas toward all the financial levels. You'll receive my ebook reader called the Wisdom World ebook reader. Over 100 of my books are already in here. Can hold 2,000. You'll receive my mother's, her legacy. The poem my father wrote about how they were married, the whole works, all the things that my mother taught me. And then my book, My Highest Persuasions. All four of these will be rushed to you. It's my way of honoring you. My way of honoring you for sowing into the Timothy house. Whatever you sow, focus it for a harvest where you want it the most. Have you not heard from your son in weeks and months? Is there a clash between you and your daughter? It seems like it'll never heal. This will be a fabulous seed for restoration, reconciliation. I never dreamed I would invest in anybody's business. Never dreamed it. Never dreamed it. But the Holy Spirit spoke to me to plant a $112 seed, $112,000 seed, into a young lady in this studio. I hardly knew her. When God decides to bless you, when God decides to bless you, nobody can stop him. Nobody can stop him. Father, I thank you that in these moments we have, I thank you for 12 people who go to the phone, call the number that's on the screen right now, and say, this is my seed, and I will sow it with expectation of a harvest. There's 12 that I ask you to talk to about sowing the $1,000 seed. This is not for a television ministry. This is to create a bedroom for a young man of God who wants to study the wisdom of God to change the world. Some of us can't leave our job. We can't sell our company, but we can sponsor a Joshua. We can sponsor an Isaiah. We can breathe life into a young Timothy. I ask you, Father, you spoke to my heart earlier about a $10,000 seed. That somebody was supposed to plant a $10,000 seed, and it would bring radical change in their world. I don't know who this person is, but I do know your sheep know your voice, and another will not follow. If what I have said about sowing seed is just for Mike Murdock's personal gain, may a curse be on me and my ministry. May my tongue cleave to the roof of my mouth. What I've said about sowing and reaping is the word of the living God. I set myself in agreement that 2014 will be the year of the spectacular, spectacular favor, spectacular honor, spectacular ideas. Thank you, Father. 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 We're receivers of your grace. I love sitting at your feet. I love hearing every word you say. I love knowing all your desires. I'm so pleasured to obey. I'm so pleasured to obey. Your favor is like sunrise. Your favor is like sunrise. Driving all my nights away. I love sitting at your feet. Holy Spirit, every single day. Yes, yes, yes. I love sitting. I love sitting at ask you for a thousandfold return according to Deuteronomy 11, 1 and 2. I ask you for a swift harvest. I ask you to open up doors never dreamed of, thought impossible. Turn this night into a collection of testimonies, unlike anything that we've ever heard, for the glory of God. It is done. In the name of Jesus, it is done. 817-509-1385. 509-1385. Glory to God. I'd like the names of the first callers if I could. I know there's somebody who's already called. Australia is watching. Heather. I love hearing from Heather, one of my precious partners. She loves me and believes in me, and she tweets me every day. Brazil. Brazil is watching. Nanny, I hope you are watching. You and your brother and his wife and your father, you are coming February the 21st to my conference. Glory to God. Eleni, I hope you're watching. Dr. Chris, I hope you're watching from Brazil. Danny, Tenorio, I hope you are watching right now. Canada is watching. Colombia is watching. The UK, Bishop Kai Dewar, I hope you're watching. Grivlin from Wales in Scotland, I hope you're watching. We had a wonderful man of God from Scotland here Sunday, a pastor who comes to my meetings in England. Wow, thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm going to be for 3 days right here at the Wisdom Center, February the 21st, 22nd, and 23rd. It's glorious, it's wonderful, and the registration number, they're going to show you that. Guys, you want to show that one more time, how to register for the 48th anniversary conference. Got a lot of things to cover with you. Praise God. Winter Wisdom Conference. I can't hardly read that. Maybe you can. There's the registration number, 888-223-2663. Two more years and I'll be in the ministry a half a century. Yeah, 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 yeah. Just call me Brother Methuselah. We want you to call and register for the conference. I'm waiting for them to bring me. I'd like to read the first name or somebody. Maybe it'll be too much or too while. We're going to be here as I go off these moments. We're going to be here for about another 30 minutes. The phone lines are open. Call and say, this is what God's speaking to me to sow. We thank you for being a part. I'm a tired boy, and we have had lots of things to do today. And I told somebody I won't go to hell for laziness for sure. But you're going to believe somebody. Everybody's believing somebody. You're going to believe somebody. So why not believe Jesus? Why not believe the Word of God? Wow. Oh, Mary. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't know if I could tell you. Pastor Reverend Tim Wellington, thank you from Indianapolis. Glenda Alexander, thank you, Regina. Thank you. Regina, I'm going to send you the Bible. I'm going to send you the Bible. Anyone that sows $300 toward the Timothy House, we're sending the Financial Freedom Bible. David from Humble, Texas. There's no amount, David. They didn't write down your seed. If you're sowing one, let me know if we didn't do it. Eva, God bless you from Walton, Georgia. Christy from Winfield. God bless you, Christy. Praise God. Christy, talk to yourself. Tell you what God's telling about you. Candace from Gadsden, Alabama. Okay. Yes, I will be sending you. Derek from Grand Prairie. I'm sending you the Passport to Healing. It's free to anybody who wants it. The Passport to Healing is free to anybody who wants it. Lance, God bless you. From Sunnyvale, California. That's a big town to me. That's where I used to have all my cassette tapes duplicated. Cindy from Columbia, Thank you for finding that what I'm looking for, Cindy. Thank you. And Mary, you know who you are right here in Fort Worth. They didn't give me your telephone number. I got a surprise for you, Mary. You don't know how much this seed means to me. I've got a surprise for you, and I'll tell you about it. Call quickly, call quickly. Move while the Holy Spirit's talking to you. Move swiftly. I believe with all my heart in the harvest. A lot of people believe in giving. Everybody believes in giving, but I believe in receiving. God bless you as we go off the air right now. Our phone lines are open. Write that down. And don't forget tomorrow night right here at the Wisdom Center, Wednesday night, tonight at 10:30, I'll be on the air on Word Network. Word Network, live every night, 10:30. Not live, taped. 10:30 every night on CST, Central Standard. My briefcases, I've got everything that you can imagine. There it is. That's the 48th anniversary. Why do they have to register for the... They don't have to register for the February 6th and 8th. I have no idea what that registration's for. You can watch it free on the internet. There's no registration for that, so I don't really know what that's about. I thought that was registering for the anniversary. I love you. Good night.